Hi, welcome to my channel. I'm Yuxuan. We have just embraced the new year. Now we are in the Lunar New Year. In this series, we will learn about visiting a friend during the Lunar New Year. As we know, due to there having lots of keywords and terms related to the festival, we will watch different conversations in this series of videos. Please remember to watch the following video, part 2. At the end of each conversation, I will explain the pronunciation and the usage of several critical words in it. Okay, let's listen to a conversation about the Lunar New Year in Taiwan. Here is the scenario. Giving New Year greetings. 拜年.
Hi, Nana.
Happy New Year!
新年快乐!
Mia Tang, wishing you great prosperity.
恭喜发财!
We are here to give our New Year blessing to you.
我们来拜年了!
Welcome, please come in.
欢迎,请进!
Do I need to take off my shoes?
请问我需要脱鞋吗?
Yes, please take off your shoes.
对,麻烦请脱鞋。Please
wait a minute.
请等一下。I'll
bring you slippers.
我拿脱鞋给你们。Here
you go.
来,请用。
Alright, thanks.
好, 谢谢.
Suit yourself.
随便坐.
Would you like some tea?
要喝点茶吗?
Hot coffee?
还是咖啡?
I will take the tea. 我喝茶就好.
I like to have coffee. Thanks.
那我要咖啡, 谢谢.
Lunar New Year's Eve, 除夕. Yesterday was Lunar New Year's Eve,
前天除夕.
Did you go home for New Year's Eve dinner?
你们回家吃年夜饭了吗?
Of course I did.
当然有啊.
A bunch of relatives was there.
一堆亲戚都来了。Eating
New Year's Eve dinner.
吃年夜饭。Is
sitting around the stove, right?
就是围炉,是吧?
Yes, in Taiwan.
对,在台湾。Everyone
has the custom of sitting around the stove.
都有围炉的习俗。Everyone
gets together for dinner.
大家聚在一起吃饭。Have
you given out the red envelopes?
你们有发压岁钱吗?
Certainly. 当然咯。This time of the year is the most painful time for me. 每年这时候,都是我最痛苦的时候。Do
you also need to give red envelopes to your parents?
你们也要给爸妈吗?
After young people get a job,
年轻人有工作以后,
they start giving out red envelopes,
就开始发红包。
Prepare them for the elders to express their gratitude.
包给长辈,
表示心意. Prepare them for the kid to express praising the kid.
包给小孩,
表示祝福. You don't have kids yet.
你们又还没有小孩.
I still have to prepare the red envelopes for some relatives' children.
还是得给亲戚的小孩呀。
On New Year's Eve, will you wash your lagar?
除夕时，你们会拜拜吗？
We need to worship our ancestors early in the morning.
一大早就要拜祖先。
Worship the God of my parents' house.
拜地基祖。
地基祖 is the God of your house.
地基祖就是你家房子的神明。
On New Year's Eve, we still have to stay up late or all night.
除夕夜，我们还得守睡。
We can't sleep until 12 o'clock.
过了十二点，才能睡觉。
What does that mean?
那代表什么意思？
Welcome the new year with the whole family.
全家一起迎接新年的来到。
Increasing life for elders.
为长辈增寿。
New year, new hope.
新年新希望。
Alright, let's now look at some of the confusing terms in this conversation. The first one, 拜年 and 拜拜 are very similar in typeface, but they represent entirely different meanings. 拜拜 is completely expressing worship, but 拜年 is to give New Year greetings.
Okay, the second.拖鞋 and 拖鞋 are pronounced the same, but they also represent entirely different meanings. 拖鞋 is to take off your shoes, but 拖鞋 represents slippers. The third, the literal meanings of 围炉 and 年夜饭 are the same.They represent people sitting together around a round table to eat dinner. They also mean reunion dinner. In terms of words, 年夜饭 is a common term, but 围炉 has an ancient poetic flavor. So the term 围炉 is mainly used in southern Fujian, China, and Taiwan.The fourth, the terms 亲戚 and 亲友 also look very similar. For example, the character 亲 in 亲戚 means closely, and the character 戚 means relatives. But in the term 亲友, we can see that the 亲 here also represents relatives.So, therefore, the term 亲友 means relatives and friends. Note that the original pronunciation of the 戚 character is 戚, but it is customarily pronounced as 戚. The fifth, 红包 and 压岁钱 also represent the same meaning. Both mean red envelope, but 红包is a common term among folks, and 压岁钱 is a term in cultural conception. These two terms are commonly used now. The sixth, 守岁 is a folk custom on New Year's Eve, represents not sleeping at night, staying up late to welcome the New Year. 真寿 means increasing the length of life.
Alright, that's all. I hope you can chat with your friends about the Lunar New Year in Mandarin during or after Lunar New Year.
Okay,
please feel free to leave me a comment or any questions. And I'll see you next time.